For more on the legal side of the Clinton email case, we have former federal prosecutor Jacob Frankel. He joins us from Salt Lake City. Thanks for being with us, sir.
Thank you, Vlad. Good morning.
So FBI Director James Comey said that there was no evidence of criminal intent on Hillary Clinton's part. But is there a substitute for criminal intent? Essentially, could prosecutors still bring charges against her even after the FBI concluded that she did not intend to break the law?
The answer is yes. Is it likely to occur? No, it's not likely to occur because there's going to be considerable deference to the decision by the FBI, by Director Comey, and particularly because the FBI is regarded very much as an independent law enforcement agency. And in fact, it is the law enforcement arm of the United States Department of Justice. But theoretically, there absolutely is a basis, and that is, although Director Comey focused on the concept of criminal intent, which we think of as an affirmative mindset to commit a criminal act, there is something in the law, and it's called deliberate ignorance, conscious avoidance, willful blindness. Those are substitutes in the law for criminal intent. Prosecutors often are using circumstantial evidence to establish the intent of an individual, and should prosecutors wish to do so and really scrutinize this case closely, I do think there is a basis to look at those standards as sort of the ostrich head in the sand defense as to a substitute here for affirmative criminal intent. Is there a basis? Yes. Do I think that it's going to happen? Absolutely not.
Well, just speaking of that, Loretta Lynch said that she was going to go by the recommendations of the FBI, but ultimately this is the Justice Department's final decision. Do you think there is room for a DOJ prosecutor to look at this case perhaps differently than the FBI did?
Emory, you hit the real issue on the head, because typically it's the flip scenario where the FBI is actually recommending a criminal prosecution and prosecutors saying, no, there is not enough evidence here. Here instead, you have the FBI saying, we're making a recommendation to decline or recommending that you not prosecute this case. So yes, there is a framework, particularly with the evidence that, not only the evidence that exists, but even Director Comey's comments yesterday, because as you listen to that press conference, I could just as easily have seen the conclusion of that press conference being one where he says, and we have made a decision to recommend to the Department of Justice to bring a prosecution under the misdemeanor statute. So yeah, there is a framework and an opportunity for prosecutors to reevaluate this case, come to a different conclusion. But again, that is not likely to occur, particularly given Attorney General Lynch's comment that they intend to follow the FBI's recommendation.
Mr. Frankel, Director Comey emphasized that there was no precedent to follow for this investigation. What's your response to that?
I think that rings a little bit hollow because the Department of Justice historically not only has pushed the envelope, but has brought cases where cases have not been brought before. And two examples that really come to mind very briefly. One is, pre-Enron, the Department of Justice was not prosecuting senior corporate officials under what's called the honest services fraud theory, the idea that senior corporate officials were depriving their shareholders or their stakeholders of the honest services of those senior corporate officials. It took the Supreme Court in the Jeffrey Skilling case ultimately to beat back the government's use of that theory. Similarly, we're talking about 8-9 years ago, the idea of prosecutions of individuals or even corporations for violating the U.S.'s international anti-corruption law, which is called the Foreign Corrupt Practices Act. That was pretty much unheard of, and now it's very common. So yeah, the Department of Justice, in with appropriate facts, will bring what we call a case of first impression, will apply a statute differently than it has done before. And this is a perfect example where it could do so.
Jacob Frankel, you are a former federal prosecutor. Thank you so much for your time.
Thank you.